Bet you're wondering how I did that. No? Then why did you click on this video? Well, either way, you're about to learn how to do this with your MiSTer via LaunchBox. Although you may be able to use this method with the launcher of your choice. There's a more detailed guide link below that has links to the programs you'll need. It also has way more information and tons of tangents. This will be more of a brisk guide that's only really referencing the Windows side of things, especially as that's all I really have figured out right now. So with that, let's get started. The reason this all works is because of this command right here. It's all one line and can be used in a command prompt to launch a game. So what we're doing is making all of the files, or at least the relevant ones, in your library into a bunch of individual batch files that then launch the corresponding game. Don't worry, we're not making these individually. That's what the various software is for. It doesn't mean that there's nothing to do on your end, it just won't be as tedious as that. Now, let me show you how I did this. First off, I've got all the programs we'll need ready to go here, and I've got my MiSTer's hard drive plugged into my PC. Now, keep in mind, I did have to get all of the files unzipped beforehand, as the launch command, to the best of my knowledge, can only call the system-specific files, not a zip file. I've also made sure Wizzo's MiSTer extensions is installed. I did it through Update All here. It's in the Tools and Scripts section. Just make sure the MiSTer extensions is toggled on. Go back and save the change, then exit and run. Then when that's done, back in the Scripts menu, run the remote script. Get that starting with your MiSTer and take note of the IP. Also, you should set a static IP, probably through your router. Now then, let's launch File List Creator. We're gonna wanna uncheck some things on the side here to get us a nice usable list of files. All right. Let's go ahead and save those settings too. Let's stick with the example in the guide and work with the Genesis. The metric system version is called Mega Drive, so let's drag that folder over. We'll click on this here to sort by extension. Now all we're interested in here are just .bin, .gen, and .md files. So anything that's not that, we're getting out of here. So it looks like just bin, md files, and that's it. Oh, this zip can go. All right, now we got our list of files. We'll uncheck format to get those out of our list. Go to save that. The default will be file list, a name we will be using again in a moment, but let's save this with a label of Mega Drive, noting that we had MD and bin files. So save that. So now a text file of that list will pop up. Go into replace and replace all backslashes with forward slashes. Save that and then exit out. Now take that file we've made and make a copy real quick. Open up Notepad++ and drag those two files in there. Make note that we'll be using the copy for the renaming process, so we'll treat that one differently. So first off, in that main list, we have to replace some characters so they'll be handled properly down the line. Go into search, then replace. Here's our list of changes. So we'll be changing all the carets to double carets, the exclamation points to caret exclamation point, the ampersands to caret ampersand, and the percents to double percents. So now here's the two main things we'll be replacing in those lists. Let's copy this bit up through the forward slash after games. Paste that here. Copy this bit. Paste that here and replace all. Jump over to the copy quick, and we'll just replace that first bit with nothing, clearing that out. Now back in the main file, we'll copy this last part here, but we really just need the last bit, but we'll need something to attach it to. So we're gonna replace .bin with this bit. And since we noted that the only other type was MD, we'll do the same for that. back in the copy, I like to remove those extensions so we get a file with only one extension at the end. Now don't forget to use those drop-down lists. Now save all, and then close all. Now we have a perfect new file to paste out the file splitter script from the linked guide. Or you can just download it. Paste that in here. Now save it as something like pound or a hashtag filesplitter.bat to keep that at the top of the list. So we'll get out of here, back to the list folder. We're going to change the main file name back to just file list. Getting that out of here. All right, so launch the file splitter and you'll get this for likely just a few seconds. And now you've got that list split into files for each line. Now we just need to rename them. So now open up FileBot. Now Control A to select all. Control click these three off. And now this is important. From the first file, drag this over to the left side of FileBot. You should see that line 100,001 first and the rest coming sequentially. Now drag that copy file over to the right side. Hit rename and alakazizam, you got a folder of files, all in the same layout as the files on the drive. Oh, we can get rid of this boot file here. Now let's just go in and make sure that worked. We'll grab one random one here. This one with the extra parenthetical crap. Edit and yeah, the one string, same extra crap, all of the stuff we added. Looks good.
1 hour later.
Yeah, I don't know why I did that in a Peter Lorre voice, but anyways, so I went ahead and did the rest of what I'm adding and have confirmed to currently work with Wizzo's script. I'm sure there's more. I also saved all of the list files just in case. Now the guide has some more notes on this and a link to the supported file types for each system. Let's also make a zip of these completed files, just in case. And finally, before we start messing with LaunchBox, we need to create or download some launcher scripts for the emulator options. Choose which one you want from the guide and paste that into a new notepad file. I'm going with the silent VBS script here. So I personally have just the one MiSTer and files are on the SD card and USB drive, so I just need two copies of this. First off, change the MiSTer IP field to match your MiSTer's IP address, the one from earlier. And that last 8182-bit should be staying the same, but the option exists for it to change in the future. Now for the first one I'm saving, I'll leave the file as is with FAT as the MiSTer drive entry for the SD card. We'll save this as launchersd.vbs. And for the stuff on the hard drive, we'll change the MiSTer drive to USB 0. And save that as launcherdrive.vbs. Okay, let's open the LaunchBox folder and place those files in the root of the Games folder. And now, on to LaunchBox. Now there's a couple ways you can do this, and in the end, the seemingly slower method actually may be the quicker depending on the current state of the bulk importing process. But the way that produces the best results, I think, is just importing one by one. The bulk importing process currently gets a bit overwhelmed with large quantities of files. It'll just lock up for potentially hours. It also won't give the option to relocate the files into the LaunchBox folder, which I would advise doing to keep all of this portable. So from here or the Tools menu afterwards, we'll select the option to import ROM files. Select Add Folder, navigate to your BAT files. We'll go with links on this one. Select the folder. Next. It'll usually guess right on the platform, but you may need to manually select it. We'll be manually configuring the emulator and adding our VBS script for the USB drive. You can call it whatever you like. Now browse to the LaunchBox Games folder and attach the launcher drive script. You'll need to select all files from the drop-down to see it. So next over and select Move Files to my LaunchBox Games folder. When you next over to the image download page, I'd at least select the box fan art, but you can obviously add whatever you like. Keep in mind that it can add up. You can pretty much next through the rest, but there may be some options that fit your needs. Well, now that we've got all that metadata downloading in the background, we can try adding another one. We'll go with the arcade cores. We'll get to the import option from the tools menu. All the same. Add folder, yada yada. Oh, this one matched fine. Okay, next. Now we'll add the SD card launcher script. Basically same as before. Ow, this populated with some stuff. Let's write over that. Get the SD script. Oh, this shouldn't be here. Let's delete that. Okay. Move the files. The last use settings here are carried forward. Some different settings here, but I'm good. Now this one tripped up the program for almost a minute, but it did finish. At least with this method, the wait won't be stunning. Finish that up. And there we go. Both of the launchers added. Now we just go down the line and get all the systems added. Alakazizzy Mikliz Nuggets. We're all finished. Made a little shortcut here with a little Mr. Coon icon. We'll pretend this launches this quick. And hey, look at that. Pretty good list of stuff. Now, let's combine those. And there we go. Yeah, it's pretty cool stuff here. like I'm trying to convince my nephew or something. Yes, yes, just like the games from Switch Online. Okay, let's actually try all this out here. Bring up a little video player streaming from my MiSTer. Okay, and wait for the network adapter. And there it goes, jeez. Click play. Oh yeah, the launcher also opens your MiSTer menu to trigger an autosave. And there we go. Now you see, nephew, the supervision was kind of like the Game Boy. What's a Game Boy? Oh my god, you kids. Alright, let's try out that SD launcher too. I don't know, we'll go with the old stick and ball there. Oh, here's the right-click menu. You can just double-click on a selected file too. Menu opens. And there we go. And that's pretty much it. I mean, you will be doing some work on this, especially with the pairing of metadata, but I will say it's better now than it was years ago, naturally. So I hope this, helps your choice paralysis. I, for one, am glad to not be crazily fixated on this project anymore, one hopes, and can focus on what I've been avoiding, finding my ass a job. Well, wish me luck. Oh, and thank you to Wizzo, Sorg, and all the contributors to the MiSTer project. And, like and subscribe or something? Something about a bell? I don't know. Alright, well, take care everybody and happy gaming.